Hey, Wingaddicts, what's going on? It's your pal Tommy. We got the whole family here, Wing Chef Brian, Don the Cleaner, and we are in Middletown, Connecticut at Eli Cannon's. This place is an institution on the corner of 15 and what? No, 9 and 3 something.
It's on the main track.
Right on Route 9, Middletown.
Right when you get off the highway. Right on. Right there on the corner.
Right on. So this place opened up back in early 1990s. All right, as one of the first craft beer pubs in all of Connecticut. And craft beer has been their thing going forward. So check this out. This guy, Rocco, was working back in the kitchen as a dishwasher way back then. He worked his way up the ladder, and he met his sweetheart, Aubrey, here at the place. They got married, and they just bought the place. And guess what they have?
Wings.
Wings. We're ready to try some.
Wings up!
So, Chef Ryan, what do we got going on here, guys?
So, the first one coming with camera, this is actually one of their signature wings. It's called Dirty Wings. Now, it's not like the dirt wings like we have talked about before, where they're sauced and fried again. This is a dry rub wing. What it quite literally is done is they just take all the spices they have in the kitchen, put them in the grinder, blend them up, make a nice dry rub powder, add a little bit of some brown sugar to it, a little bit of salt, and then just drench the wings after they fry them. So, it's got a crispy, dry rub of just who knows what flavor you're gonna get on each bite.
Oh my God, and it smells delicious.
Next one here, this is their General Tso's sauce. So those are sticky, delicious, look at that nice Asian flair in there. I mean, those just look nice and glazed. This one here, it's called Two in the Pool.
Two in the Pool?
Two in the bush.
So now, the meaning behind that one is basically that they've been fried, buffaloed, and then barbecued. So they got those two flavors.
Fried buffalo and barbecue.
And then this one here is just nice. A nice classic medium buffalo. We're looking for a little heat, not too much there. Nice little bit of butter taste in there. Vinegar is what I'm looking for. They make all their sauces here in-house, all their dry rubs in-house.
I once knew a medium buffalo.
A medium?
He was very cute.
And he once knew a medium from buffalo.
What do we got here, Ryan?
That one there is their sriracha honey. So that's gonna be spicy and sweet. Everyone knows sriracha. Sriracha's got that nice little sting to it. It's Korean ketchup, pretty much.
I like that, Korean ketchup.
Fellas, we got two in the pool, five on the table. I think it's time to eat. Where do we begin? Because I am dying to get into these. They smell amazing.
Why don't we start at the beginning?
Start at the beginning.
Let's go with the dry rub first.
Thank you, sir.
Wings up.
Wings up.
Wings up.
Let us gingerly touch our tips.
So what is this?
This is their dirt dry rub.
All right.
Ooh, wow. That's just like pulling bones out here.
Oh my God. Falling off the bone.
That's a good dry rub. And it is.
That's sweet. It's coated on there. The dry rub normally that falls off.
It's
because
sweet.
They add that
it's
sugar
salty.
To it.
It's tangy.
You don't know what it is. It's just there. And it tastes good.
Oh man, they're tender. And hot. Temp hot.
I can't. It's like every dry rub I've ever tasted.
Look at the smoke.
In one wing.
Look at the smoke coming off of that. Can you see that?
But you know what? It's funny you say smoky because they are. They got a smoky taste to them too. Mm. Wow.
Look how clean that is. I mean, there's nothing left on that bone.
That's a clean one.
But yeah, that's a very interesting. I'm getting a little bit of spice, a little bit of smoke, a little bit of sweet. I mean, that's just interesting. And like I said, it's every spice they got. So you don't know what flavor. I mean, the next one you eat probably has a different flavor.
I'm not going to show you mine.
Let's go to the next one. Let's move right down the line here.
Yeah, these are small.
These are smaller wings than we're normally used to, but you know, you're frying them up, falling off the bone.
I tell you what, I like them small.
This is General Tso's.
You can eat more.
Asian
this is the
flavor.
General?
Mm-hmm. Not the car insurance, though.
No, not him. Oh, yeah.
I got it. Bye-bye.
It's a good wing.
It's solid. It's a solid general.
Tasty.
Generally
I'm a fan.
Tasty. So far, that dry rub is a winner for me.
Yeah, that dry rub was really good.
That was excellent.
I'm looking for this two in the pool.
All right. It's called Two in the Pool.
Two in the pool, one in my mouth. Yes. No.
How would you
no.
Right here? How do you
should have said that wrong.
How do you say two in the pool in Spanish?
I'm gonna clean this.
Okay.
Is everyone okay over here?
Doing great. Thank you.
You're doing awesome. Thank you. I think we're all set. All
right, cool.
That two in the pool was good. I mean, the cartilage is just popping off these pools.
That's a good flavor. I taste the, you know, the buffalo. It's a blend, right?
A little bit of spice, a little bit of sweet, a little bit of mesquite from that barbecue that's in there. You know, it's a great round of
flavor. I like that. That's nice.
Mosquito?
It's a little different.
This here is the nice
medium
buffalo. And it's made in-house, so for each one, they just make their base hot sauce, and then they do a little flare-up. So I think you said the medium one, they do a little bit of some habanero sauce in there, a little bit of butter. Just keep that heat, but give it that nice little glaze flavor.
I like that. It's a little above medium.
That's got that vinegar bite in the middle.
Yeah.
And that tells me more of a nice prepared wing, fresh sauce, adding a little extra vinegar to that sauce before it's served.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
I wonder what the hot's like, because that's got some hot to it. I don't want to know. I'm not ordering it. I'm not ready for that. But I am ready for this.
Sriracha honey's next.
I've kind of really been waiting for this one. Go with my flats.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, that smells spicy.
Wow.
Look at that. Like, I just turned that and just all fell right off the bone.
They are so tender. A nice, that's a nice flavor. Subtle. You got that sriracha snap.
That sriracha heat.
Yeah.
But sweet.
You know what? I'm gonna say this again. I like the size of these wings because you can order a bunch of different flavors.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're not filling up a bunch, and you're not filling up on it.
And you're also not sitting there trying to mow down a wing that's like, when you know, sometimes when you get the wings and they're all different sizes, you get the small ones fall off the bone, then you get that one big one, and you're sitting there chewing on it because it's not as tender as all the others. All these are equal sized wings falling right off the bone. Means you can get to the next one just that much sooner.
No doubt.
But, yeah. Eli Cannons, guys.
Middletown.
Eli's.
They're doing it right. I mean, it's...
I'll tell you what. They got some killer beer menu,
too. Yeah, they're... Because they're also... They're a tap room. So, I mean, they're changing out beers daily, bringing in some beers that no other pubs and bars are going to have out there that you're going to find. I mean, I'm drinking the Heady Topper made by Alchemist. That is a great beer. I'm talking.
And he's working.
I should be doing that.
Okay, we're sitting indoors because it's season four back indoors, but you know what? If it wasn't raining outside, we'd be out back at this big old patio setup they have out there that looks absolutely amazing.
Yeah, it's also, I mean, this place is not just even just come here for the food and the beer. It is like nostalgia city inside here. I mean, they got
it's cool
stuff all over the walls, all like chalk drawings on the brick that have been here since the building first opened, and they kept it original the way it was.
Like
they're
it.
Doing the wings right. The menu looks great. Beer selection is awesome. Perfect place to come down, chill with your friends, have some great food, great time.
No doubt. Come to Eli Cannon's, tell them the Wing Addict sent you. Write your name on the wall. Bring some chalk, bring some spray paint, whatever. Get your names all over the place. And you see these little cartoon dudes right here? Click on that and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can see all of our wing escapades throughout the beginning of time. Till now.
Make sure you get on Facebook too, because you gotta follow us. We got a lot of stuff going on there.
Check out the community, post your stuff, and wings up.
Wings up!
Wings up!
Hey guys, Eli Cannons, we're all finished. We got a boneyard we're getting ready to take a picture of. And
look at all those bones.
Our server bones. Colby comes out and says, do you wanna try the lava sauce? And you know what? I lava sauce. Just the name. We have to try something.
She gave us some chips, but I'm going to celery shake.
I don't need a chip. We're going with veggies. These guys already smelled it, and it smells scary.
They're stupid. I'm not doing this.
Okay, Tommy, dip it, and we'll cry together.
I need a bigger spoon on mine.
Oh, my God. They're so going to cry together.
Wings up. Celery's up, people. Most people don't get this because of lava.
It's too hot.
Somebody's gonna get hurt.
It's too hot.
Because it's cold and it's not on a hot wing yet, it's really not activated in the palate. But my mouth's warming it up. She does fine.
I feel great.
I'm not going to show emotion.
Yeah, you are. You're going to cry in about 30 seconds. Yeah, you are.
Lava.
Ooh, you're here.
Ooh. Man, I lava you. We lava you.
Wow.
Wings up.
Wings up.
Okay.